Welcome to another God at Home Live on Kardec Radio, always nourishing our souls. We are here together, dear friends, in this beautiful intercontinental classroom to study the laws that govern the universe. Why shall we spend time studying those laws? According to Allan Kardec, our beautiful educator and researcher, as we study the laws that govern the universe, dear friends, we are more likely to align ourselves with our own divine nature, with our divine creator, become more conscious co-creators with God. And as we become more conscious co-creators with God, dear friends, we are better equipped to nourish our own happiness, our own feeling of serenity and contentment, and we are better able to support one another in the name of our Creator. So we have many beautiful reasons, dear friends, why we are here together to nourish our souls. And we also know, dear friends, that as we gather with the purpose to do the God at home, we bring our Creator closer to ourselves, starting with the temple of our own very hearts, as we consciously connect with our Mother, Father, God. The temple of our own hearts become more enlightened. And as we open our physical homes to study the laws of the universe, dear friends, we also do engage in an act of charity. Why do we say that? Because even if we are alone from the standpoint of our physical perspective or environment, we are never alone from the perspective of our spiritual reality. As Kardec points out in the very spirits book, the discarnate spirits, our discarnate friends, influence us more than we can even imagine. So right now, our very own spirit mentors are with us, dear friends. And the familiar spirits are also surrounding us. We are forming this beautiful current of light and divine love. And to allow this current to be potentiated all the more, how do we start our God at home? With a prayer to connect the Wi-Fi of our very own hearts to that of the Creator. Shall we then unite thoughts, words, feelings, and intentions together, elevating our thoughts to the ultimate source of love, kindness, and compassion in the universe? Beautiful Mother, Father, God, we are so grateful for the gift of this very reincarnation. You have blessed us with the opportunity to light the candle of faith and discernment in one. Through the spiritist understanding of life, we are better equipped to serve you, to co-create with you, making this reincarnation the most precious, the most blessed one. We pray together so that the crumbs of our hearts can unite with that of our Master Jesus. And through his loving hands, he may bring love and understanding to those who lack spiritual nourishment at the moment. He may bring kindness and hope to those who may be overtaken by despair. He may bring joy and compassion to those who may be overwhelmed by sadness temporarily. And he may allow the light of the good news of the fact that we are all children of God to shine in all of our hearts. We symbolically give our beloved Master Jesus roses of compassion, light, and hope, asking him to distribute those roses from his loving heart throughout the earth so that his presence may be felt in the four corners of our beautiful home. And so be it. We are so grateful for the opportunity to feel and experience the love of our Creator together, because together is always better, right, dear friends? Law of Society. Tonight we are going to study the Law of Destruction. Once again, we are going to focus our attention on questions 736 and 737. So if you have the book together with you and you would like to follow us, please feel free to do so. And we are blessed, dear friends, as always, to be studying these laws because they bring light to all of our hearts and because they also help us re-signify the meaning of destruction. We now, through the Spirit's book, come to understand that destruction is but one of the ways in which God allows for our lives to be transformed, always for the better. Yes, because we know through the Spiritist science that we always progress and never regress. So let us now bring our attention to question 736. It reads, Kardec asks, are those peoples specially meritorious who, in regard to the taking of animal life, carry their scrupulousness to excess? Answer from the illuminated spirits, dear friends. Their sentiment in regard to this matter, though laudable in itself, being carried to excess, becomes an abuse in its turn, and its merit, moreover, is neutralized by abuses of many other sorts. That sentiment on their part is the result of superstitious fear rather than of true gentleness. So we learn yet again, dear friends, the importance of moderation, that yes, we are to respect all forms of life, and we are to embrace all kingdoms of nature, knowing that our brother and sister animals and plants are beautiful children of God, and we are being invited always to respect all forms of life, knowing that they are divine in nature, and that our friends, our brothers and sisters in the lower kingdom, dear friends, are interning with us, their older brothers and sisters, in order to learn to progress always. So it is an honor for us to coexist with our little brothers and sisters. But as always, the spirit mentors can see through us, through our true, most deep motivation. So they tell us that if we are careful with our little brother and sister animals and plants and minerals, just because we think that that's politically correct or acceptable, they can see through our true intentions. So they are calling us to be coherent, to mean what we say and mean what we do and put in heart and soul and intention and action together in one. What a beautiful exercise, right, dear friends, to learn to be coherent. What does it mean to be coherent? What it means is to align our thoughts, our choices, our intentions, our feelings with our words and actions. Beautiful, right? Beautiful exercise. So anytime we decide to take a particular course of action, we can ask ourselves, am I truly aligned in terms of my thoughts, my feelings, my intentions, my words, and finally my actions? We are multi-dimensional beings in progress, so obviously, because of that, our choices affect others as well. So it's important for us to study as we are doing right now, so we can better equip ourselves to be more conscious of our choices. Beautiful exercise for us, right here in our Brazil. It's wonderful to see you, dear friend. Big hug and big kiss, beautiful child of God. Thank you for joining us. So let's see what question 737 shall bring us. Question 736 brought us a beautiful reminder of how important it is for us to be coherent, even when we are acting with our lower level but beautiful brother and sisters in the other kingdoms of life. Once again, the law, the golden rule that our Master Jesus has brought us with his loving heart also applies to the lower kingdoms. Do unto others what we would like to receive. The golden rule, beautiful reminder. Now we move together, dear friends, to question 737. Question 737 in the Spirit's book brings us to another section under the Law of Destruction. The section is entitled Destructive Calamities. Question 737 reads as follows. What is the aim of God in visiting mankind with destructive calamities? This is a very important and valid question, especially currently, right, dear friends, as the world undergoes this period of great transition. We are seeing natural disasters taking place, natural calamities taking place in several areas of the world. And we, of course, are blessed with the opportunity to understand why these calamities may take place from a spiritual perspective. As the spirit mentor André Luiz always invites us, it is important for us incarnate spirits at the moment to wear bifocal glasses. We are incarnated, but we are aware that our physical existence is temporary and that we are spirits who are constantly in evolution. So with this in mind, and knowing that God is supreme and infinite, unchangeable, unconditional love, we are ready to hear and read the answer from the illuminated spirits. So why do calamities take place? The answer: to make humankind advance more quickly. Have we not told you that destruction is necessary to the moral regeneration of spirits who accomplish a new step of their purification in each new existence? In order to appreciate any process correctly, you must see its results. You judge merely from your personal point of view, and you therefore regard those inflictions as calamities because of the temporary injury they cause you. But such upsettings are often needed in order to make you reach more quickly a better order of things and to effect in a few years what you would otherwise have taken centuries to accomplish. Hello, Juliana, dear friend, beautiful child of God. So wonderful to see you. Big hug and big kiss to you and our beautiful family. Wonderful to see you, dear friend. So we see here, dear friends, that we are invited through the lenses of the illuminated minds that see much beyond what our physical eyes can see to re-signify the meaning of calamities. What we call calamities in the eyes of God are opportunities for us to progress all the more quickly. They invite us to examine the results of those calamities. For instance, right now, in the United States of America, there is a Hurricane Dorian that may be in the pathway of Florida. God is so loving and so wonderful that we already see the gathering of everyone in that state and beyond to help one another, to show compassion, to show love. We see people working together. We see friends from other states, like the mayor of New York, offering support to those in the state of Florida. We see the Red Cross already asking for donations. We see that everyone is coming together to help one another. We see everyone working so diligently. So even in the midst of what we call a disaster, we see togetherness, we see compassion, we see faith. And usually, as a result of a situation that is so challenging, such as this, improvements in security, improvements in weather forecasting, improvements of all sorts come about, dear friends. So what the spirit mentors are telling us is very, very beautiful and true, that even in circumstances that are very challenging, we see how those challenges are there to push us forward as push-ups for the soul. It's as if God were saying to us, you can do it. I know you can move forward even faster. Let me provide you with the situation so you can find the treasures that already lie beautifully within yourselves, like diamonds in a rough. Like, you know, when we find a diamond, we have to open it up and clean it up because it looks very rough around the edges at first. In order for it to look beautiful as we see it, we need to really work through it. What we call disastrous situations are in fact opportunities for us to take the edges off and to learn to work together all the more. Right, Melissa Deline? Welcome, dear friend. Big hug to you. So we see compassion, kindness, togetherness emerging already all the more when situations such as this take place. So we are able to find the kindness and the goodness of God, even literally in the eye of a hurricane. Do we wish that upon ourselves or upon others? Obviously, we don't. We wish kindness, we wish peace, we wish well-being, we wish hope, We wish love, we wish healing onto everyone always, but we are being invited to see the opportunities for growth, even in challenging circumstances. So therapeutic quiz for us today. Can we think of a challenging circumstance that after a while, in retrospect, can bring to us an opportunity for growth? Can we together, individually, with the help of our spirit mentors who love us, think of a challenging circumstance in our lives that have brought the best in us, that have brought talents, treasures that we held within our hearts that were otherwise latent but invisible to us? Beautiful exercise for our souls as we work out in the gym of the soul here, right, Gabriel Inácio? Wonderful to see you. Big hug. So yes, our beautiful soul challenge today is to find growth, development, enlightenment in the heart of a difficulty, an apparent difficulty that has become a blessing in disguise for us. If we see here, destruction, letting go of the old as an opportunity for growth. Shall we, dear friends? Oh, so wonderful to see you. Thank you, Gabriel Inácio. Hello to you. It's always wonderful to have you around. Thank you. Hello, Paula. We miss you so much. Big hug. Hello, everyone. Wonderful to see you always. So we are feeling all the more blessed, dear friends, because we see God's goodness, God's love manifesting everywhere. Beautiful, right? Seeking the good always. And in order for us to seek the good, thank you, Gabriel Inácio. God bless you. You're always nourishing your soul, following the footsteps of our Master Jesus, always seeking the good and sharing the good. Thank you, Gabriel Inácio. God bless you. So speaking of blessings, since we are together here committed to finding the blessings in the skies, so shall we say a prayer to thank God for everything that we have received and to ask for God's opportunity to give all the more, shall we, dear friends? So let us, feeling all the love that nourishes our souls, close our eyes, but unite our hearts as one, elevating our thoughts and feelings and hopes inside of our hearts to our Master Jesus. Let us visualize all the gifts that we have received in this lifetime, in this beautiful day, as a bouquet of roses that we shall give to our Master Jesus' loving hands. As one in one heart, we thank our Master Jesus for the thorns along the way. For the thorns are in fact a staircase that brings us closer to His loving heart. We pray for everyone who has been an instrument of change, transformation, and destruction in our lives. We thank them deeply and sincerely for the opportunity that they have given us to find the talents that shine from within. We offer them roses of peace, compassion, reconciliation from soul to soul. And we visualize bridges of friendship, understanding, and forgiveness emerging from our Master Jesus' heart, connecting to our hearts, connecting to the hearts of everyone in our networks, in both realms of life, bringing it forward to the cities where we are, to our homes, to our workplaces, to the United States of America, and from the United States of America to the entire world. We visualize our Master Jesus' loving hands sustaining all these bridges of light, bringing more hope, more spiritual and physical nourishment, more compassion and more joy to every heart on this earth. We thank our Mother, Father, God for this blessed reincarnation, for the light of faith that nourishes us, sustains us, and guides us. And we pray together so that we may have all the more opportunities, the eyes that see, the heart that feels, and the ear that hears the call from the Master to serve and give always. And with much gratitude in our hearts, we ask for permission to end our studies tonight. And so be it. Thank you, dear friends. This little light of ours, we are gonna let it shine. This little light of ours, we are gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Many blessings, dear friends. It's wonderful to be together in this beautiful intercontinental classroom. Big hug, and may we feel the blessings of God's love in the temple of our hearts always. Much love, dear friends. Until next time.